Good afternoon, friends. Today we are starting our new project with the company STIIN, and we bought this wonderful model for this project. It's called Maxima. This is an analog of a very popular model in Europe, which is called PRG8. If we translate it, it will mean a bee. If you remember, we had an ant, which we showed to you not so long ago. In Europe, it's a bee, and in India, it's Maxima, the model Maxima, which is produced by the company Bajaj. Why have we taken this model? It is produced with multi-million batches, and today it's not electrified in India. And we recently got some messages from New Delhi, and it was clear that by 2025 they are going to electrify all tricycles like that, to use electric traction for them. So we want to propose our option. I think that it is a very successful one. Today, this is an electric motor with combined winding Slavyanka. Why so? Because it's very economical. And in this case, we can use not only the battery, we can also use a solar panel. Let's start with disassembly of this tricycle. We will show how we will disassemble it. And we will show you our model, which does not have any analogs in the world. Let's go! Dear partners, we have some good news for you. This amazing machine, Bajaj Maxima, was remade. It used to have a diesel motor, now it has an electronic one. We will now drive it, we will show you the solar panel, the motor, the battery, the controller, how we did it and why we did it. I will now tell you why it is this very model. This tricycle model is the most common one in the world, and it is used as commercial small vehicles. In India alone, there are 1 billion tricycles like that, and by Indian law, within the next 5 years, all these tricycles must become electrified. That's why we created a kit for this model, in order not to use any brackets, not to use any openings. We just take it and we modernize it to make an electric version out of it. It has just arrived from the plant. It's all covered with film. We did not change anything. The gas handle is there from the plant, the battery is there. It is responsible for headlights, for turn signals, for a klaxon horn. We have installed two relays. This is reverse gear, forward gear, ecological and non-ecological modes. And here we see the charge of the battery. The gearbox is in place. Now we are using the fifth gear, and otherwise you can use any one, the first, the second, the third one. This is what it looks like from the interior. Let's go! You see it's now on the fifth gear, and the motor 90S is coping easily with that. The original speedometer is working correctly. It used to show the volume of the fuel. Now we don't need any fuel for that. The headlights, the turn signals, the cigarette lighter, everything is working correctly on the original systems that used to be there. Let's go. By the way, it is capable of high maneuvering. Did you see how it turned on the spot? So, this commercial transport is used in many countries, all over. In Russia, people are not used to it, but in countries such as India and even in Europe, they use it a lot. In Europe, they use them for ambulant coffee houses, for bakeries. They make them in such tricycles, and it is the first tricycle which works, which uses solar panels, and we will see in the further tests how it will just drive using the solar panel energy without even using this its lithium battery. Friends, this is the chief engineer who created this wonder. His name is Vitaly. We are now looking at this kit. This is what it looks like, and Vitaly will tell us about it. We installed it using all the basic openings. We did not change anything, we did not drill anything, we did not weld anything on. Vitaly, what is this motor? How did you install it? This is an induction 3 kW motor. It's modernized. We took off the diesel motor, and then we put just an electric motor on the adapter plate using the bushing. So the gearbox is the standard one, and then you just put the 90S motor. Right, we did not drill anything, we did not remake anything, we did not cut any thread. Everything is just like original. So the diesel motor just used to be there. How much space did it take? It took all the space here. So it became lighter and there is more room there. Well, we don't know why we actually need that room, but it's lighter, it's good. The diesel one, it made a lot of sounds, it stuttered, and you needed to change liquids. It even has special light, source of light for maintenance, you know, to put it out in a more convenient way. As far as I understand, it will now need much less maintenance. I don't think that it will ever need maintenance. You will just need to change oil in the box. And the box is operating as well, right? Yes, and all the five gears are there. And as far as I understand, this is the controller box. And it is a transformer, an adapter. It's for the solar panel to charge the battery, right? And the charger of the original battery from our battery. And this huge battery, it is for 54 ampere hours. Okay, so, and all this kit, it's the motor, the controller, and the battery, right? It all makes up a kit. Right, and once again, it's all designed in such a way that we take a similar model, we take out the motor, we don't drill, we don't saw anything, we don't change anything, and we just install it all there in a very reliable way, absolutely. What about protection from dust and from humidity? It's all by IT65. It means that even if it rains, even if it snows, there won't be any short circuits. Yes, as I see, it's all wonderfully done. We took into account exploitation conditions, operation conditions, even in our climate, without even speaking of warm countries. So it used to be a diesel motor, but was there any information about the bearing capacity? The documents, 500, 700 kilos. Is it true that this small motor will be able to do the same thing? Absolutely, without any problem at all. We kept the original gears on the gearbox, and you can choose the optimal gear depending on the conditions for this motor to operate in the most convenient way. If you need to go rapidly, then it's the fifth gear. If there is a lot of cargo, a lot of load, it will be the first, the second gear, and it will be easy to drive. So it actually started to drive better with this new kit. It is a module mode, and if something breaks down, it means that we can replace the motor, the brackets, we can fix it right in the box. Everything is as convenient as possible for the end users who will be able to change something themselves. It's all accessible. Absolutely, you can change everything without any problem at all. You don't need to have any particular skills to repair it, you just need to read the instructions. Vitaly, this vehicle was rather designed for India and it's not very common here. And they have a different climate, it's very hot, very humid there. What about heat? Can anything break down if it's very hot outside? I don't think so. All the constitutive elements, they were designed for the heat, and the motor won't overheat either. It does not overheat. And this is a separate radiator for electronics, right? It's there. And there is no forced cooling. It doesn't need it. No, it doesn't. Where we need forced cooling for charging, it is there. It is installed there. I have seen some other elements inside. What are they? They are controllers of solar panels. Okay, solar panels controllers are in the cab and the charger is in the cab. Everything that does not like humidity and water and dust, we put all of that in the cab. So nothing is to suffer from the conditions. Everything which is outside can be frozen, can be humidified, right, and everything which is fragile is hidden in the cab. I see that there are wires from solar panel here. Is there a real possibility for us to remove this huge battery from here and just to take energy from the solar panel and just go? We can't really do without the solar, without the battery at all, because there must be a small unit there. The solar panel will not provide the necessary current for the vehicle to start off. It needs current to start off. And then, when the vehicle has started off, when it is driving, then the solar panel will be sufficient to provide all the necessary energy. Theoretically, it is possible not to charge this battery at all if we are on the sunny side. Absolutely. It will be without motion for some time and it will be charging. When it is driving, it is charging as well. At any time, whether it is going, driving or not moving anything, the solar panel charges our main battery. Vitaly, it seems to be very profitable for commercial use, for taxi drivers, for delivery people. They will save a lot of money, not just on diesel, but also on electricity, right? Delivery people, for example, he or she has arrived, and while everything is unloaded, the main battery is charged from the solar panel. Same goes for taxi drivers. While they're waiting, the battery is charged. According to calculations, there won't be any need to use the socket. But still, you installed it there. Yes, just in case, you know, there are different situations that may occur. I've heard a story that when delivery men, when pizza delivery people started to use electric vehicles, they just had a second salary. They just took the money that was meant for fuel, right, for fuel and for maintenance, for servicing. Servicing is very expensive, and this one does not need any servicing at all. At all. No. The motor doesn't need any maintenance. Just change oil in the box. But you know how often it must be changed. Just once a year at most. Look, this is a lithium iron phosphate battery. And what if this vehicle is used in India and they want to install a lead battery? Is it possible? Yes, absolutely. For example, they don't want to use this thing and they want to install a lead battery, and all the system will be working all the same? Yes, it will be working all the same. That's just great. I know that in India they like lead batteries. They all use lead batteries. You can save on batteries. It's just that maybe they will not have such a long life and you will have to replace them more often. And these ones, they serve for a long time and there are big warranties. Okay, that's clear. Friends, look how huge this solar panel is. We now have very like small winter sun, but there are still 44 volts from each side of the panel. And by calculations, it will drive without charging of the battery. So this solar panel must suffice. They are our Russian solar panels, but the kit actually means installing any solar panels, Indian, Chinese ones. We have just taken the Russian one because it's more convenient. This is the first day when this wonder left the shop floor. We drove around a little bit, we made a little review, we have seen what is inside, what is outside. In the near future, please expect a big review. We will speak about all the technical characteristics, how much it accelerated, how much it could cover using one charge, without solar panels, with solar panels. There will be a big review. Please wait for it. And that's it for now.